Do you want to set up your own business email address? If you're running any kind of online business, you're going to want your own custom email address and not just a regular Gmail account. Whatever platform you're growing your business on, you're going to need an email address. So today we're going to go over how to set up a business email account with Google Workspace. Welcome to Entrepreneur's Toolbox. My name is Jonathan Dunkerley, and I'm here to help you find the tools to make an income online. Google Workspace is the evolution of Google's G Suite. Workspace offers many features, but the only one that we're going to really be diving into today is their email feature, or in particular, their feature that allows you to have a business email address associated with your domain. By the end of this video, you're going to be able to take your domain and create a custom email address for your business. I may use a few terms that you don't understand, but I will do my best to make sure that it's super easy to follow, so let's dive in. Now, this is Google Workspace. You could go to workspace.google.com to find this, or you could just go to the link in the description of this video. Now, they have a couple different plans. You don't need anything crazy to get started with just using this to have an email for your business. So you could just get started with Business Starter. So I'm just gonna click Business Starter. And you can give it a business name. You could just put in your name here. I'm just gonna put my name. Then it's gonna ask you how many employees, including yourself, there are. If it's just you, just click just you. Then select the country that you're in and hit next. Then again, fill in your name first and last, and then another email address. This could be another Gmail account, or it could be another third-party email address. And when you're ready, hit next. On the next page, it's gonna ask you, does your business have a domain? If you've purchased your domain from other sites like GoDaddy or Namecheap, then you're gonna click, yes, I have one I can use. If you haven't, you could either buy one from one of those places, or you could just buy it directly on Google by clicking, no, I need one. If you end up getting one from Google, you could just search the available domain names and then purchase it directly from Google. But today we're going to click, yes, I have one I can use. So I'm going to use the domain for my first and last name. And then I'm going to confirm that I am not a robot. And then I click next. Then it will ask you if you want to opt in to emails that will educate you about Google Workspace. This is optional. You could say no, or you could say yes, or you could opt out later. I'm just going to say okay, and I can opt out later. Now we're going to create a username and password for our email address. So I'm just going to create Jonathan. So it would be jonathan@jonathandunkerley.com, and then create a strong password and then verify I'm not a robot and agree and continue. So now it's going to have me log in. So there's my email address, jonathan@jonathandunkerley.com. I'm going to hit next, and then I'm going to enter in my password. So now I'm going to do their 14-day trial. And then after that, it is going to be $6 per month. If you have any kind of promotion code, enter it here and then click next. On the next page, you're going to need to put in your name, your business name, and your mailing address, as well as your payment information, just in case you go beyond the 14-day trial. If you cancel before the 14-day trial, then you will not be charged. And when you're ready, hit agree and continue, and then continue to set up. This will take you to your admin controls. Now that we have our account set up, we're going to need to verify our domain in the DNS settings. I'm going to show you how to do this with Namecheap, but it's pretty much the same no matter where you bought your domain. So the next thing that you're going to need to do is protect your domain. So mine is jonathandunkerley.com, and I bought my domain through Namecheap. So we're going to go ahead and click protect. Now, I purchased my domain through Namecheap, and it automatically detected that. It says, when Namecheap publishes your new DNS record, we'll look for the verification code. So I'm gonna click, I'm ready to protect my domain. And you're gonna wanna log into your domain. I'm using Namecheap. So you'll do this with whoever has control over your domain. Domain list, and then I'm doing this for jonathandunkerley.com, and I'm just gonna click manage. Then I'm gonna click advanced DNS. So what we're gonna need to do under advanced DNS is add a new record, and we're gonna add a text record. So we click add new record, scroll down to text record, and then under host, we follow the instructions that the Google document gives us. So host record is at, and then the text value is included right here. So we're just gonna copy the text value. Host was the at symbol, and text value is what we just copied from the document that Google gave us. When we're ready, we just hit the check mark. Once that's ready, we come back to the admin panel and click protect domain. So it's checking the verification records for jonathandunkerley.com, and it could take up to 5 minutes. So you can go off and do something else and come back to this later. And success, our domain is protected. If you're getting value from this video, be sure that you smash that like button, drop a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified every time that a new video goes live. You can create up to 10 users using your account. It is free during the free trial, but then they charge for these after the free trial is done. So you could try these out during your trial, and if it's something that you want for your business, then you could add it in. You could also create aliases for your email address, like info@jonathandunkerley.com or sales@jonathandunkerley.com or contact@jonathandunkerley.com. So whatever you need, you could actually give a unique email address so people contact that particular one. And then when we're ready, we hit continue. If you'd like to add additional users, you could do it here. I'm not going to right now. I'm just going to hit continue. Because I didn't add any additional users, I didn't get the little check, but I am done with this step. Now I'm going to activate Gmail for jonathandunkerley.com, and this will route all the emails to this Gmail inbox. So I'm going to hit activate. We're almost at the finish line. All we have to do is activate our email address. So a similar box just popped up. Before you begin, are all existing Jonathan Dunkerley emails backed up? So this is just if you're moving it from another email client. So they want to make sure that your emails are backed up. So I'm just going to hit, I'm ready to activate Gmail. So the next step in my case is going to be on Namecheap. It could be on GoDaddy or wherever you got your domain or wherever it's pointing to. So on Namecheap, you would click on domain list and then click on manage. And then advanced DNS. You're just going to go down to mail settings. You could either do it manually and then you'd have to copy and paste everything in manually, or you could scroll down to Gmail, click Gmail and hit save changes. And this should automatically update it on the other end. Once you've done that, click activate Gmail. Now it is checking for when it updates on the Namecheap or your domain provider's website. It could take up to 5 minutes. So you might just need to come back to this page in just a few minutes. If you set everything up correctly, it should say, good job, your MX records are updated. Then you can just click finish. And that's it here. I know it says that it's 67% done, but we didn't create any new users. So you could just click skip now. Now to get to your email, you just click on these dots in the top corner and click on Gmail. And you're set up. This is your business email address on Google Workspace. Just click get started. And then if you want to make sure that it works, just send an email to that email address just to verify that everything is set up correctly. I sent an email to myself as a test. Here we go. Test Jonathan, email went through successfully. And that is how you could set up a business email address with Google Workspace. If you have a business or do any email marketing, you need a professional business email address. Google Workspace makes it super simple for anyone to create a professional email address in no time at all. Have you started email marketing? Let us know in the comments. If you like this video, check out this video next. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. And if you got value, make sure that you like, subscribe, and ring the bell, and I will see you in the next one.